Hello dear students, a very warm good morning to all of you and welcome back in our biology session. So we are discussing our lesson and the name of the lesson is what? Reproduction in animals. So in that already we have discussed some points. We have discussed about the fertilization, types of fertilization. We have discussed about the male and the female reproductive organs also. So today during this biology session we are going to see about the next point, that first we will discuss about the IVF. Now what is mean by IVF? So already we have discussed about the fertilization, internal fertilization and the external fertilization. Internal fertilization, what happens? The development of the embryo happens in the female's body, okay? The fertilization happens in the female's body, then it is called as what? Internal fertilization. While if the fertilization happens outside the female's body, then it is called as what? External fertilization. So in that, now on that basis of that same point, we will discuss about the IVF. What is mean by IVF? So as we know how the fertilization happens, so in the fallopian tube the fertilization happens, but in some women or in the some women this fallopian tube or this oviduct is closed, okay? The fallopian tube or the oviduct is closed, and because of that what happened? The eggs cannot get transferred into the fallopian tube, and that is the reason the fertilization doesn't occurs in the fallopian tube or in the oviduct. So in that case what happened? Freshly released mature eggs and the sperms are collected outside and they are keeping as it is for a while for the process of fertilization, and that process is also called as what? IVF. That is only what? In vitro fertilization. So I stands for in, V stands for vitro, F stands for fertilization. So in vitro fertilization, what is mean by the in vitro fertilization? The fertilization happens outside the body, okay? So outside the body, and that is called as what? IVF, in vitro fertilization. So the mixing of the sperm and the mixing of the eggs happens outside the body of female, that is called as what? IVF. So that after the fertilization, or they keep the eggs and the sperm as it is, and in case if the fertilization takes place, then they are keeping that fertilized egg as it is, and then that fertilized egg gets converted into the zygote, okay? And that zygote get transplanted into the female's body or into the female's uterus, and then that uterus, or they after the placing that zygote into the female's uterus, that zygote started to grow slowly, and that zygote get converted into the new individual, and the woman is giving the birth to that baby as usually the other woman is giving, okay? So in this way, this is about what? IVF. The baby is born with the help of this technique, that babies are called as what? Test tube babies, okay? It doesn't mean that the baby is growing inside the test tube, okay? The fertilization only happens outside, but the after fertilization zygote form, and that zygote get implanted in the female's uterus, and then that woman is giving the birth to the baby. So let's discuss about the development of embryo. Fertilization result in the formation of zygote, that we have already discussed, okay? When there is a fusion of the male gamete and the female gamete, then it really is produced the zygote, okay? Then that fertilization causes the or produces the zygote, okay? So here I will write the zygote. After fertilization, what happens? There is the formation of zygote. That zygote started to get developed into an embryo. The zygote started to get develops into an embryo, okay? Okay, so what we have seen, that the zygote, how the zygote form? After the fertilization of the sperms and the egg, there is a formation of zygote, and that zygote begins to get developed into an embryo. So what is the embryo? How the embryo is get developed from the zygote? So once the zygote form, the zygote started to divide repeatedly to form a number of cell or to form a ball of cell. After that, the cell started started to or that cell begins to form a tissue started to form a group and they started to produce the different organs of the body. So this developing structure of the zygote is called as what? Embryo. This developing structure of the zygote is called an embryo. And after that, this embryo is get embedded in the wall of the uterus. In the wall of the uterus, here you can say that, okay, embedded means what? It gets placed into, it comes into the wall of the uterus, and in that uterus the further development of the embryo is takes place. Okay, once the embryo is get embedded in the wall of the uterus, the further development is happens in the embryo. The embryo is started to get the different body parts like legs, hand, ear, eyes, nose. So all these body parts started to forms in the embryo in the uterus. Okay, so the stage, in that stage what happened? The embryos are having the body parts which are identifying, or the identifying body parts, and that stage is called as what? Fetus. The stage is called as what? Fetus. Okay, so what is this fetus? The fetus is the stage in that what happened? The embryo is having all the body parts or the all the identifying body parts, and that stage or that stage is called as what? Fetus. Okay, so see here again I will repeat what is meant by the zygote. Zygote is the fertilization or the fertilized egg. How the egg get fertilized? With the fusion of the male and the female gametes, or with the fusion of the sperms and the eggs. Once this zygote formed, then that zygote started to divide repeatedly, forms the number of the cell or the ball of the cell. That cell begins to form the group and forms the tissue, and after that the tissue started to form a different organs. Okay, so this is about what? Embryo. And that developing structure of the zygote is called as what? Embryo. Once this embryo gets embedded into the uterus, then the further development is happens in the embryo, and that embryo started to get developed. That embryo is gradually develops having the different body parts such as legs, hand, ear, nose, and that stage of an embryo in that all the body parts are identifying, that stage is called as what? Fetus. Okay, that stage is called as what? Fetus. And after that, once the baby get mature, then after the 9th month the mother is giving the birth to the baby. Okay, so this is about what? Development of embryo. Now we will go through the diagram. Okay, so once the egg is get mature, it get released from the ovaries and it comes into the oviduct. That in the oviduct what happen? There is a fertilization process is happens in the oviduct, and then there is a fertilization means what happen? The fusion of the eggs and the sperms is happens in this oviduct. After the fertilization, zygote is formed, and this zygote started to repeatedly divide and forms the number of the cell. This number of the cells started to forms the embryo, and then embryo is get embedded into the uterus, and again the uterus is having the different body parts. Okay, so this is the development of embryo. Now we will discuss about the hen. In the case of the hen, there is also what? Internal fertilization. Okay, but as you see, the hen is giving the directly birth to the chicks. No, obviously the answer will be no. Then how the hen is giving the birth to the chicks or to their small babies or their small one? So let's discuss about that. So as we know, in the hen also there is a external fertilization happens. The fertilization of the egg is happens inside the oviduct. In the hen also the internal fertilization happens, and once the internal fertilization is happen, the zygote is travels down in the oviduct. While traveling down, the zygote repeatedly get divide and started to form some protective layers on it. Okay, so as we have seen the eggs, on the eggs there are the hard shell. Okay, or that hard shell is also the one part of that protective layers or the protective covering. Once that protective layers or the protective covering is get finished, then the hens lays the egg. Once the hen lays the egg, in that eggs the embryo takes the 3 weeks to get converts into the chick. But this is not an easy process. So that embryo get converted into the chicks, but for that process that embryo requires the warmth, okay, and that warmth is given by the hen. How? That hen is sitting on the eggs. By sitting on the egg, the hen is providing the warmth to the egg, and that process is called as what? Incubation. Okay, so in that incubation what happened? The hen is sitting on the egg and providing the warmth to the hens, warmth to the eggs, and from that eggs what happened? That embryos get converted into the chick within the 3 weeks. Okay, after the chick is completely developed, then what happened? That chicks comes out through the egg by breaking that protective layer, or that process we can say that what? Hatching. So after the development is completely done, then that what happened? The chicks break that protective layer and comes out from the egg, okay, and that is we are calling as what? Hatching. Okay, so in this way there is a production of the new one baby happens in the hen. Okay, so in the hen also there is a internal fertilization, but the babies are comes out from the eggs. It means what? The hen is a oviparous animal, while the mammals like a cow, dog, human beings also, all these are the giving the birth to their young ones directly. That's why they are what? Viviparous. Okay, so this is all about what? Development of embryo. This is all about today. We will stop here. We'll meet in the next video for the next point, for the discussion of the next point. Here we will stop. We'll meet in the next video, and for today, thank you.